Thank you. Annapurna and Aarti, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Igor. Aarti, would you start?
Yes, of course. So warm greetings to the moderator of the session, audience, and the entire education, open education community. Today, I, Aarti Yadav, and my co-presenter, Annapurna Madhuri, are here to present on the topic, A Pathway Towards Enhancing Quality of MOOC, Perspective of Students. I and my co-presenter have developed and offered MOOC under Open Education for Better World online mentoring program. And as developer, we felt the need to know more about the perspective of students regarding the MOOC they attend. The findings of the study will provide useful information for the developers to improve upon the accessibility and quality of their MOOCs. Now I invite Annapurna to reflect further upon the research objectives. Annapurna.
Thank you, Aarti. So taking this forward, let us first understand the background of our study. Do we really need to chalk out a pathway for evolving the quality of MOOCs, enhancing the quality of MOOCs? Do we need to evaluate the MOOCs from the perspective of the learners? Perhaps yes. Whether we want it or not, MOOCs are here to stay. And so there is a drastic need to create quality MOOCs dealing with the challenges of creation, curation, deployment, and access. The present study against this background is an effort to understand the needs of the learners and use the insights to overcome the challenges in designing better learning experiences for the learners. The study reflects on students' experiences related to the course openness, massiveness, degree of communication, collaboration, certification, social inclusion, quality assurance, and assessment strategies. The paper, let me tell you, was rated strong. So as being rated strong by the reviewers, we felt that we had been extra responsible, and we have put up our best efforts to make enough so that it may be utilized by the developers in designing engaging learning experiences to the learners. So the research objectives, we have kept it very short. We have only 3 research objectives: to assess the reach of the MOOCs in terms of openness and degree of freedom exercised by the learners. Second one is to comprehend the expectation of the beneficiaries in terms of course content, assessment, communication, collaboration, and certification. And the third one is evaluate all the points to be considered to make quality open access educational content on the basis of the study, which is related to the first 2 objectives. So the method we adopted was a survey method, and we designed a questionnaire for the participants. The questionnaire contained 31 items, and so we administered the questionnaire to the people who had taken any kind of online courses offered in the Indian context, right from OE for BW MOOCs to the Swayam, NPTEL, and also courses available on other platforms. The data says that we had 56.9% of our people were males and 43.1% were females. Most of the participants, the respondents for this, were from the age group 20 to 29, that is 66.2%. And the age group above 50 was only 3.1%. All the respondents were from India. So the complete study is based on the Indian context itself. So talking about the first objective, so we tried to access the MOOCs in terms of their the reach, the access to the people, openness, and the degree of freedom exercised by the learners. So in that category, we first talked about the source of information. How did the learners come to know about the course? So 66% of the respondents said that they got to know about the course from their institution itself. So this reflects a culture where MOOCs are a part of the institutions, or at least are becoming a part of the institutions. So they are backed up by the institutions, and that is huge for us. Then we talked about the platform on which the course was offered. So the most popular platform is OpenLearn, in which we had around 21.5% of the people enrolling in today's courses. Then we had Moodle, in which 16.9% of the respondents had enrolled. Then NPTEL comes the next, with 17% of our respondents enrolled in courses offered by NPTEL. And Swayam and Mookit follow with 15.4% of the enrollments each. So the language in which the course was offered was largely English. So one course was offered in Hindi, and 3% of the people suggested that it would be good if the courses would be offered in other languages as well. So India being a multilingual country, there's a vast scope of having these MOOCs in multiple languages, so that it reaches a large amount of population. So that said, the platform that was considered, we asked the learners about the ease of access to these platforms in terms of signing up for the course, login for the course, viewing and downloading the course content, submitting and resubmitting the assignments, and to participate in the discussion forum. So we had 81.5% of the participants saying that the login to access the course was very easy in the platforms which they opted for. Then we had 76.9% of the people said that the signing up for the course was also easy given the platforms, and we had 73.8% people saying that the view and the viewing and downloading the content was also good when it comes to the said platforms. So that said, moving further, we also talked about the degree of freedom to use the content. So this talks about how freely they could access the content. So the freedom to download the content, 73.8% participants felt that it was very high. The degree of freedom was very high. And then we had freedom to access the course was all content after the course is over is also rated good. But then the participants said that they had a little lesser freedom to complete the course beyond the stipulated time, and also to submit the assignments beyond the stipulated time. So degree of openness in terms of enrolling and learning. So we had the openness in admission, order of the content, order of the content, where they could start from.
It looks like we have lost Annapurna.
Should I take forward?
Yeah, it looks like Annapurna is losing her connection. I think perhaps RT, if you would please take over.
Yes. I will try to share.
I'm back. I'm sorry for the connectivity issues.
Okay, Annapurna.
Okay, it seems like we have Annapurna back, but doesn't look.
So continuing with the degree of openness in terms of enrolling, was it from here? Can I start, Aarti, or is that fine?
Yes, it's okay.
Yeah. Let's continue. So we were talking about the ease in admission and order of taking the course content and the how self-paced it was. So we had large number of participants voting for saying that it was very easy to access the course at any time, whenever they wanted, and it was self-paced. 64.1% of the population of the respondents said that it was self-paced. We also talked about the digital openness in terms of access to the course, access to the platform on which the course was offered, and also access to the text material, audio video material, and the courseware which was offered. So we had 75.8% people telling us that the access to the platform was very easy, and then access to the course was also easy, and this was the responses from 72.3% of the respondents was that the access to the course was easy. Also, the courseware, access to the courseware was easy, and this was said by 70.07% of the respondents. So with this, I pass it on to Aarti. Aarti, you may continue.
Okay. Fine. So I would like to take forward and reflect upon the second research question that is the focus two of our study. And here I would be discussing the issues in terms of course content, assessment, communication, collaboration, and certification. And before I go ahead, I would like to apprise you that 46.2% of the participants in a study took up courses belonging to higher education category. And coming to the level they adopted, they opted for, I would say that 57.4% participants took up 32.8% went for the basic level courses. And now when we talk about the certification, so we asked the of feel that strongly certificates are essential for several reasons. And they say that the certificates provide them motivation and they are essential document required. They are also required as an to be added as an additional skill set in the resume. So the developers have to consider certificate as very essential, and it is highly preferred by the participants. Next slide, please. This next slide reflects upon a very important or a very critical information about what are the reasons which are considered by the participants or the learners of the course behind dropout. So, 50% of the respondents say that they never thought of dropping out of the course, but the rest 50% they have cited several reasons. 90% they have other priorities in life. And due to other important priorities in life, they can drop out of the course. Then 13% talked about the fast pace of the course as an obstacle. Then 10% talks about they have failed to understand the concept of the course. And 7% talks of lack of personal assistance as a reason for dropping out. And these four reasons which have been cited by the respondents are really important for the developers to understand and to work upon so that they can retain more attract more learners in their courses and thus improve upon their accessibility of the course. Next slide, Annapurna. Yeah, thank you. So here, these are the best aspects of the course which the participants have reflected upon. They think that the smooth flow of the topic, the simple course content, the easy to understand course content, the easy to understand language, these are the best aspects of the course. Then they also feel that the content of the course adds to their existing knowledge. They are satisfied with the reflective assignments too. But now, here what we can see is that the learners feel that if the sufficient notifications are not provided, the feedback or by developer is lacking, assignments can be improved by incorporating innovative elements in them, presentations can be more interactive. So these are the areas which are rated less in comparison to the content part, smooth flow and the course content part. So these are the areas which the developer while developing can work up a better way. Next slide. Yeah, thank you. So now if we talk about assessment, here in this study, I particularly want to take your focus upon not on the best aspects of the course which the learners think. Of course, that is a motivation to the developer. But on the aspects which the learners have rated poor, the which the learners have rated fair, or the which the learners, which the aspects which the learner do not consider as the best aspects of the course. Similarly, when we talk about assessment, we see that reflective assignments, they are highly satisfied. They have rated it really good. And quiz questions, of course, they have rated it good. But when we see group assignments and collaboration, we see that the number of participants which rate it as poor are maximum. So this is the area which I feel that, which the data suggests that the developer has to take care of while designing their group assignments or collaboration. And so that this poor rating, you know, what it suggests is that this has to be worked out. That how the group assignments or the collaboration should be better planned and designed. Next slide, please, Annapurna. Yeah, thank you. And now coming to the communication. So what were the most channels of communication used in the courses? So it has been, it is very clearly, the data very clearly shows that significantly used as the channel of communication by the instructors, while the WhatsApp, the Telegram, synchronous sessions, messages, hangouts were there, but in a very insignificant manner. However, emails and discussion forums are very prominent channels of communication used in the courses. Okay, please, next slide. Fine. So now here, I would like to draw your attention to what the learners feel about the enjoyability of the course. So they, I have shown this regarding group assignment, it is considered as the least enjoyable. Worksheets provided for the future use, least enjoyable. Now, as we move forward, we see the discussion forum, and they are pretty comfortable, or they feel it is enjoyable with the reflective assignments, with the interactive explanation, with the quizzes. So these aspects are the good aspects which they feel they are enjoying. But where a developer can see that they have to work upon, again, the group assignment and collaboration is coming in the picture. And as reflected by Annapurna, discussion forum and lack of supplementary and worksheets provided are the aspects which have to be worked upon. Next slide, please. So on the basis of the data, what the data has been speaking in the focus one and two, now we would like to conclude upon that what points should be considered to make quality open access educational content. Please, next. So we can see that on the basis of whatever the data which has been looking at, we see that the first of all, we see that the channels of communication, the most preferred were email and discussion forum. So there is a need, the learners feel, you know, that somewhere the connection between the learner and developer is lacking. So there is a need to build strong connection with the learners. And by adopting, this can be by adopting communication directly address their issues, like we can adopt, we can go for synchronous sessions. It also addresses the problem of lack of personal assistance, as we have previously seen in the data, that they had problems. They were thinking of dropping out due to lack of personal assistance and support during the course. So we have to ensure active participation of learners on discussion forum. Then when we talk about the collaboration in form of group assignments, we need the attention of the developers, as the learners have shown that collaborative activities are least enjoyable. So the results show that there is a need to improve the planning, the designing, and the execution of the collaborative activities. It is not so that they are not enjoying the collaborative activities. Maybe the activities, they are not getting exactly how to collaborate in the activities, how to put their best efforts in activities. Yeah, so this has to be taken care of to build a learner-centric MOOC. Next slide, please. Now regarding the flexibility, the most often cited difficulty throughout the study, it is shown that there is a rigid time limit for submission of assignments and rigid time of closure of the course. And this aspect of rigidity has to be worked upon to provide more flexibility for submission of the assignments, to take the course, to learn where they can retain the learners in the course, and also to meet their learning needs in terms of flexibility. And of course, certification is considered as a very important aspect, as it provides motivation to them and also required for their professional, as a document for their professional development. And when we come to the assessment, we have seen that reflective assignments and quizzes are really enjoyed by the learners, while worksheet for future use and group assignments need improvement. So these were the few conclusions we could draw upon from the data you have seen. I hope these conclusions and the data provided hope all the developers. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much to both of you, Aarti and Annapurna. I really appreciate your insights. Unfortunately, we ran out of time, so we don't have time for questions, but there is a question from Ingrid Defoe in the chat window. I do encourage you to engage with Ingrid's question in the chat asynchronously, but we do need to actually move to another presenter. So thank you very much again for your contribution. Stay safe and please enjoy the rest of the conference. Thank you.
Thank you, Igor. You too, stay safe. Bye-bye.